ILTV Plus, your news from Israel and more 24/7. Start your free trial today. Subscribe at ILTV.tv and watch from any device. In other news, the Gaza-based Hamas terror group now making new and unlikely enemies to the north. A new report by the Alma Research Center finding that Hamas is increasing its activities in southern Lebanon with the aim of threatening Israel on two fronts. But Hamas's actions are apparently angering the Lebanese terror group Hezbollah as a pseudo-turf war begins to bubble. Middle East expert and lecturer with Bar-Ilan University, Dr. Mordechai Kedar, with the analysis. Dr. Kedar, thanks so much for being with us. Now, both groups are Iran-funded proxies. Both groups want the destruction of Israel, ostensibly, and Hamas has been operating in Lebanon for decades already. So what exactly is the problem? What changed?
Well, the question is, to whom Lebanon belongs? As we know, Hezbollah claims that Lebanon belongs to Hezbollah. After all, Hezbollah is a Lebanese organization, and they pose themselves as the owners of Lebanon, especially now when Lebanon is totally dysfunctional as a state. However, don't forget that in Lebanon there are some 10 refugee camps of Palestinians since 1948, and these camps are actually extraterritorial for the Lebanese government mundo 1969, already 50 years. It means that the Lebanese government has no say about what is happening in these refugee camps. Therefore, many Palestinian terror organizations like Hamas and the Fronts and many others succeeded to have roots in these refugee camps, and they do in these refugee camps whatever they like, including Hamas. So now the question is, will Hamas be able to operate on Lebanon, on Lebanon's soil, which technically belongs to Hezbollah? And here is the source of the problem.
So how do you see this conflict between Hamas and Hezbollah resolving, if at all? And you know, does Hezbollah feel the same way about these other terror groups, like, as you mentioned, you know, the PFLP and the Islamic Jihad, etc.?
Look, as long as Hamas restricts its activities to the refugee camps, nobody really cares. The problem is, what will be if Hamas tries to recruit the Sunni minority of Lebanon, which is not Palestinian? If they do this, they are in a direct clash with Hezbollah. So I do think that the Hamas will actually know what the limits are. And if Hamas doesn't know what the limits are, Hezbollah will teach Hamas what the limits of Hamas are.
All right, now, the Alma report adds that when Hamas attacks Israel from Lebanon, Hezbollah actually gets dragged in, even if it is against Hezbollah's immediate interests, as we've seen somewhat recently. How else might this conflict actually involve Israel or endanger Israel, and how do you think Israel will respond?
Well, what happened in August is that Hamas tried to ignite the situation between Israel and Lebanon in order to drag Hezbollah into this problem. But Hezbollah apparently have more brains than Hamas, and they understood that they do not want to get in any trouble with Israel at this point, because getting into trouble with Israel means that they have to use their stockpile of missiles against Israel. And this is something which the Iranians, who supplied them with this stockpile of missiles, would never allow Hezbollah to do again after they did it already in 2006, because Iran wants to keep this arsenal of missiles ready for the real confrontation with Israel, which might be if Israel attacks the nuclear facilities of Iran.
And do you see Israel responding in some way to any of these attacks, or is Israel also maybe just as smart as Hezbollah in this respect?
No, I think that Israel knows what Hamas wants to do, and Israel will not be dragged into a confrontation with Hezbollah, because don't forget that August, when it happened, it was the peak of the tourism season in the north, and many thousands of Israelis were in the north, in zimmers, in hotels, and you know, in the wherever they were, and Israel didn't want at that time to ignite the border between Israel and Lebanon.
All right, Dr. Kedar, thank you so much for your insights.
Thank you so much.
ILTV Plus, your news from Israel and more 24/7. Start your free trial today. Subscribe at ILTV.tv and watch from any device.